Hello everybody, today we'll see very very important, interesting as well as very beautiful theorem that is called as Thevenin's theorem. Students find difficulty with this theorem, so only I'm uploading about it. Simple concept it is, any complicated network can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with a resistance. I repeat, any complicated network can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with a resistance. Now, what do you mean by complicated network? It is nothing but linear bilateral network. Coming to single voltage source, what type of voltage source it is? That is called as Thevenin's voltage source or open circuit voltage. Then what is that resistor? It is called as Thevenin's resistance. Okay, I hope you clear about the statement. Any complicated network can be replaced by a simple network which consists of a single voltage source in series with a resistor. That's all. So what are the steps we need to follow for this is only 5 steps. So I'll show you in terms of an example. Once I'll explain the steps, by, I'll solve that so that it is easy for you to get the clarity. Let's start. I'm taking this example. I'm taking, let it be a current source of 2 amps. In here 10 ohms voltage and a source of, this is also 10 volt, another resistor, it is of 5 ohms, and here one resistor of 1 ohm. Imagine this is the circuit given and they are asking you to find the current here. Clear? Now what is step 1? Identify the load resistor and remove it. Identify the load resistor and remove it. Now, how to identify load resistor? The current across which, the resistor across which you want to find current, that is nothing but your load resistor. Here in the circuit, you see, they are asking to find the current across this. So, that is your load resistor. That is your first step. We need to replace it. How much it is? 1 ohm. So, first replace. Your first part over. Now, it is becomes open. Clear? What is step 2? Find VOC or VTH, that is open circuit voltage or VTH across it. That is the concept, step 2. Now how to find VOC here, open circuit, let it be AB. I want to find VAB, that is nothing but VOC. This is nothing also called as the Thevenin's voltage. Now you can apply the KCL or even you can apply the KVL. Choice is yours. I am most comfortable with KCL because it's very shortcut. So imagine this 2 point is nothing but a single node. So what voltage it is? You can just replace this and connect like this or not. Single voltage, it is also the same or not. So the incoming current, it is minus 2. Now whenever you are going to apply the KVL, always assume that it's a higher potential. So what will write? B minus 10 by 10. Then here no source. So B by 5 equal to a 0. Take the LCM, what you will get? V minus 10 plus 2V equal to, it will go to this side, 2 into 10. Clear? So it will give you 3 volt equal to 30 implies V equal to 10 volt. This is nothing but your open circuit voltage or Thevenin's voltage. If you are very much comfortable with KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, then you can apply here and you can check your answer. Definitely it will match with 10 volt. Clear? This is the step 2 over. Now go to step 3. Find the RTH. What is the condition of finding RTH? Replace the active source. What are the active sources present? Either current source or voltage source. It should be replaced by the internal resistance. So how much is internal resistance? For current source, the internal resistance is infinity. So it should be replaced by open circuit. For voltage source, the internal impedance is nothing but 0. So it should be replaced by short circuit. Now let us see the same circuit. What you need to do? Now this is your current source. First one, it should be replaced by open circuit. So make it like this. Now this is the resistor, 10 ohms. This is voltage source, should be replaced by short circuit. So I am making it short. Now ahead of this, there is a 5 ohm resistor. Across this open circuit, you should keep your eye and you should look towards it. Clear? You imagine that there is a source connected, so current is flowing. Now what is happening? Here there is division. You know, whenever there is division takes place, that terminals are connected in parallel. Right? Now here this path is open, so current is circulating here. This is nothing but it is in series, this path. Now this is, so 10 and 5 is parallel because you are looking from this side. Which side? Looking from this side. So now what is your RTH? It is nothing but 5 parallel 10. So 15 by 50, that is 3 by 10 equal to 3.33 ohms. Clear? Now come for the fourth step. What they have told? Draw the VTH in series with RTH. Now you got your VTH. This is nothing but your VTH. RTH is 3.3. So draw it. This is your RTH in series with VTH. How much it is? 10 volt. It is 3.33 ohms. Over. Fourth step. Now what is fifth step? Connect back your resistor RL. What is your resistor RL? You have removed your initial circuit. That is 1 ohm. So connect it back. This is your resistor RL. Now they are asking simply what is the current here. Usual apply the Ohm's law. So what is the current? I equal to V by R. Here what is V? V is VTH by RTH plus RL. So VTH is how much? It is 10 volt divided by RTH is 3.33 plus RL is 1. So 10 by 4.33, this much of amp. That's all. Yeah? So simple or not? Now what is the concept behind it? Any complicated network, you can simply make the reduction. How the way you can make the reduction? Simply you connect a series voltage along with a resistor. That's all. A voltage source in series with the resistor. Now what is the step one? Find out the branch where you need to find out the current. Replace that resistor. First step. Second, once you replace that resistor, across that point you find the open circuit voltage. That is called as Thevenin's voltage. Step two over. Now third is you need to find out Thevenin's resistance. So you need to replace your active voltage sources or current sources by their equivalent circuit. If it is a voltage source, you should replace it by a short circuit. If it is a current source, you need to replace it by a open circuit. Replace. Then once you replace it, you will find the Thevenin's resistance. Then fourth step, you connect back your VTH and RTH in series. That is what Thevenin's theorem states. Any complicated network can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with a single resistor. That's what this is nothing but your equivalent Thevenin's resistance. Got it? Once you got it, fifth step is nothing but connect back your resistance RL. Now you connect back. Now it is a simple circuit where your Ohm's law, you can apply it to find the current I equal to V by R. You can take any example. You will enjoy. And you can cross verify the same by applying your KCL, KVL, whatever the laws you know. You can apply and you can check. It will be applicable and damn sure you will get the same answer. Okay friends, take care. Bye bye.